Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Alifa Nadia Ramadhani Taha. I'm 15 and I'm from Bogor. So let's set the scene, shall we? Imagine that we are as one indigenous community and we are the ones that facing the unresponsible problem from the government. That's horrible, right? Terrible. So, indigenous peoples, unfairness, and economic development. Those three words represent what I'm going to talk about right now, which is protecting the rights of indigenous communities in developing economies that justifies exploitation as necessary means. At the economic development, actually everybody's rights must be protected, including indigenous communities. Their existence is as important as anybody else's. With our participation as the global citizens, in protecting them, I hope that it will give the recognitions and the rights to the communities as they deserve. So, indigenous peoples are the original people that lived in some countries, islands, etc. But time flies, immigrants came to their places to colonize them and took over everything that they have built or made for such a long time, the communities, I mean. However, all things that happened in the past brought such a significant impact to the present day. And according to ILO, or International Labour Organization, there are approximately 476.6 million indigenous peoples globally, divided into 5,000 communities spread around 90 countries worldwide. Furthermore, in Indonesia itself, there are around 50 to 70 million members of indigenous peoples, or called masyarakat adat or pribumi. In developing economies in this present time, the government often excluded the communities in it. They keep using the natural resources that actually belong to the indigenous communities, but most of the times, the government violates indigenous peoples' rights. So what did the communities get from it? For instance, lack of political representation and participation, economic marginalization and poverty, lack of access to social services, and of course, discrimination. With the lands, countries, natures, societies, and others that they had made in the past, way before the immigrants came, they don't deserve all of those such things. Now let's dig a little more about economic development, shall we? Economic development is the process of improving the economy of a nation, region, local community, or an individual to reach well-being and quality according to targeted goals and objectives. But conditions at a country to another are pretty much different, hence the handling of it doesn't progress similarly. It implies economic growth and some essential variety of areas that determine the well-being of the people, such as health, education, security, human capital, and so on. I believe that all countries will 100% use the benefit of the environment or nature in their lands as maximum as they need to make their country's economy developed higher than other countries. In developing economies, the government is actually supposed to include all citizens without any doubt to give their opinions and actions about the law and system that would take place and time where they live in. But unfortunately, that doesn't imply to all countries because of the selfishness that the elites, the government have inside themselves. They're only minding their own business and exploit what others have and keeping their mouth shut instead, especially when it comes to indigenous communities. In this case, to break the silence and giving the voices and role that they deserve, that the community deserved, we firstly have to educate ourselves more about what it is and start to take action in it, such as share the information and raise the awareness and others, you know? Then let me tell you something. Use your privilege and voices for good and wisely to help them, you know? Due to the close relationship between indigenous peoples and economic situations and their environmental settings, Indigenous rights issues are often linked with concerns over environmental change and sustainable development. They also have the right to maintain the country's economic, political, social, legal, and cultural institutions while protecting their rights to participate fully at the country development, especially in the economy area where it will use lands where their ancestors have built in the past. The United Nations is now trying to reach an agenda for 2030. I know, like, it's a long time, a decade project called the Sustainable Development Goals, or SDGs. This program tries to achieve the goals in 17 areas of focus to protect the planet and ensure that all people. With all people, it means all societies, including the indigenous communities, to enjoy peace and prosperity by 2030. We must help to uplift their voices, help protect their rights on this earth. How? That's the only question that I know. To avoid misinformation before we spread the words out, we should educate ourselves more and then educate others around us through the platforms that we have or directly to them. And if any of you guys have a powerful voice that will make a more significant impact on it, please use it to draw others' attention to keep up with the information and campaigns to support the SDGs about this indigenous communities' rights. We can sign the petitions, donate some money to those who need, and always support them, support the communities through everything, ups and downs. Remember that we're all in this together, or else the world will be torn apart. Nevertheless, even though all the activists and indigenous peoples already spread the words, but there is no still act from others, from us, we could never, never reach the goals, you know? So please, I need you guys to wake up, open your eyes. There are so many things going on in this world. The founders of the countries we live in right now are facing the unfairness, the unresponsible mess from the government. They cannot participate in developing economies for the future. They provided us the perfect nature, the perfect society, the perfect condition to live in, and all of a sudden we forget them, we ignore their existence. No, that cannot be happening. We should stop it and drop the act as soon as possible. That's all I got. Thank you guys for your guys' attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.